Hello dear students, in this video we will solve exercise of lesson 4, nutrition in living organisms. Classify according to food type. Okay, so you have to classify these animals and insects and all according to their food type. Okay, so you all know very well, we have to convert it into herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous, scavengers, decomposers, saprotrophic, parasitic, like that. So I will say one by one. Tiger, I will classify, tiger, carnivorous. Cow, herbivorous. Vulture, scavengers. Bacteria, decomposers. Deer, herbivorous. Goat, herbivorous. Human, omnivorous. Fungus, decomposers. Means saprotrophic and decomposers in one column, you write it down. Okay, lion, carnivorous. Sparrow, omnivorous. Buffalo, herbivorous. Frog, carnivorous. Cockroach, omnivorous. Tick, parasitic. Okay, next, match the pairs. First, parasitic plant, Cuscata. Insectivorous plant, Drosera. Saprophytic plant, mushroom. Symbiotic plant, lichen. Next, question number 3, answer the following questions in your own words. Why do living organisms need nutrition? Answer, living organisms need nutrition for the following reasons. First point, for the continuous supply of energy to perform work. Second point, to help in the growth and development of the body. Third point, to replace the worn out tissue and to repair the damaged tissues. Fourth point, to have a resistance to infections and diseases. Second question, explain the process of production of food in plants. Answer, first point, the plants prepare the food by the process of photosynthesis. Plants absorb water and minerals present in the soil with the help of roots. Second point, the carbon dioxide is taken from the air, and with the help of chlorophyll, in the presence of sunlight, plant prepares glucose in the process of photosynthesis. Third point, in the process, oxygen is liberated by the plant. And fourth, chemical reaction of photosynthesis. Children, you have to write this. This one, page number 26, now CO2 plus H2O. This next question, what is meant by parasitic plants? Name their different types with examples of each. Answer, first, the plants that depend on other plants for their nutrition are called parasitic plants. Second, the parasitic plants are heterotrophic in their mode of nutrition. Some of them lack chlorophyll and thus cannot perform photosynthesis on their own. Third, Loranthus is partial parasite. It sucks the nutrition from its host but prepares its own food. Fourth point, Cuscata or Dodder does not have chlorophyll. It looks yellow, wire-like climber. Hence, it is complete parasite on the host tree. Next, explain the various steps of nutrition in animals. Children, you can write this paragraph. Steps in nutrition. Got it? This will be the answer for you all. 5 steps of nutrition in animals. Got it? Ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, ejection. This paragraph. Yellow highlighted portion, you have to write it down. Next. Name some unicellular organisms in which all life processes takes place within their unicellular body. Answer: amoeba, euglena, paramecium are the unicellular organisms in which all the life processes takes place within a single cell. Give reason. Insectivorous plants are attractively colored. Answer: insectivorous plants feed on insects. They need to capture the insects. In order to attract these insects towards the plant, they are attractively colored. Second, butterflies have a long tube-like proboscis. Answer: every insect is provided with mouth parts for ingestion. It feeds on nectar and pollen from the flowers. It thus has a tube-like proboscis to suck this food from flower. Now children, nutrition. Prepare and complete the flow chart according to the type of nutrition. Nutrition, then plants and animals. In plants, autotrophic, heterotrophic and symbiotic. Then from heterotrophic, insectivorous, saprophytic. Okay, now animals: holozoic, saprozoic, parasitic. And from parasitic, ectoparasitic and endoparasitic. Got it? Now think and answer. First, we prepare a variety of foodstuffs and dishes at home. Are we then autotrophic organisms? Answer. First point, we prepare variety of foodstuffs by using grains, pulses, vegetables, etc. Second point, these provisions are given to us by plants. This supply, per provision means supply. We may also prepare food from flesh and eggs of other animals. Third point, we cannot perform photosynthesis wherein we can actually synthesize the food matter. Fourth, hence we are not autotrophs, we are heterotrophs. Second, which organisms are greater in number, autotrophs or heterotrophs? Why? The number of autotrophs is certainly more. The number of plants should be more so that they can be enough for the herbivores. Herbivores are dependent upon autotrophs. If autotroph decrease in numbers, the heterotrophs too will starve and die. Therefore, in nature, the autotrophs are always more than the heterotrophs to balance the food chain. Third, the number of heterotrophs found in desert regions is smaller. However, they are found in greater numbers in the sea. Why is this so? Answer. First, in desert region, the autotrophs are lesser in number as well as heterotrophs dependent on them are also less. Second point, the food is scarce, therefore the number of heterotrophs also reduces. Third, in oceans and seas, there are multitude of zooplankton and phytoplankton, spelling Z-O-O PLANKTON, and phytoplankton PHYTOPLANKTON. Phytoplankton are very small, microscopic floating plants which we may not see. Fourth point, the food chain in the seas is dependent on these planktonic species. Therefore, the number of heterotrophs found in desert regions is smaller, but they are found in greater numbers in the sea. Fourth point, what damage or harm do ectoparasitic and endoparasitic animals cause? Answer, first point, the parasitic organisms depend on the host for its nutrition. Second, ectoparasites have specialized mouth parts. With the help of these, they suck the blood. Example, mosquito and bed bugs. The biting insects cause a lot of discomfort. Third point, mosquitoes spread many diseases such as malaria, dengue, and elephantiasis. Fourth, endoparasites live inside the body of host. Example, roundworm, hookworm, pinworm, etc. Fifth, they absorb host's nutrients and cause malnourishment to the host. Both ectoparasites and endoparasites cause damage to our health. Next, why is plant food not produced in any other parts of the plant except the green ones? Answer, the chlorophyll is present in the green parts of the plants. In these parts, photosynthesis takes place. This produces food. The non-green parts do not produce food due to lack of chlorophyll. Children, here exercise is over. Thank you.